Now, I do want us to look at the film a little bit more carefully. Basically, a film is the whole process of how a chemical process is used to convert light. And basically, it is the energy of the light itself that changes the chemicals. And then, of course, we have to figure out how to preserve that changed in chemical process to then basically be able to store light into film. Here I've just laid out a simple 35 millimeter film, pretty much like the same one that I'm showing here. And I've basically kind of now unwrapped it in the schematic to show different parts of a film. So in this instance, light is coming in. And if you'd noticed, even in this one, the light was coming in from that side. And that was the one that was pointing to the optics, the lens of the camera. The light comes in, and of course, there are many different layers. Let's just go quickly over them and see what each one of them does. First layer is a protective layer. We need to be able to protect all of these light-sensitive layers that are actually going to exist. Of course, in most types of cameras and films like this, we also put in a UV filter. The UV filter is there to just make sure that the right kinds of light and not damaging lights are hitting the different types of sensors. Ignore the colors of these types of things. Each one of them has a different feature. So the first one when the light hits is a blue light layer. Then a yellow filter is added to kind of get the yellow light out. Green light layer, red light layer. So again, we have green, red, and blue lights. Then there is an adhesive which is put in there. So these are all very thin layers. And of course, the thickest one is the film base, which gives it the structure and keeps it stable. So in essence, all of this is tied up in something this thin. So it's important to note that not only in the present days, people can pack things up in small things. A lot of this packed up into a very small thing there. So in essence, a film is a sheet of plastic. And that's what I've shown you so far. It's coated with an emulsion that is basically full of light-sensitive silver halide salts, which have been bonded by a gelatin. So in essence, there are silver halide salts inside the layers. These are the light-sensitive ones that actually store the light changes. And then there are variable crystals all over the film also that basically determine the sensitivity, the contrast, and resolution of the film. This is where some issues like ISO come in, because this is where all of that practical ability of how sensitive that film is comes in.